Hello everyone, my name is Fabian Błonka. Welcome to Grasstick and hope you are doing well. Today we will continue our work with modeling the steel and reinforced concrete complex bridge structure. And today we will focus on modeling the foot with coupling between wings and walls and foots. Let me show you. Here is. This is our goal model, exactly the part of this goal model. I get rid of the deck because it is unnecessary for us to be seen for this presentation. Today we have to do those couplings between wings, walls and foot. Next we have to do to model the foot. If we look at those foot from the top, we can see that we can divide those foot into some sub areas. Here is the most simple one because the division in this direction and in this direction has been already determined by the division of the wings and the walls. Next, we have to make this area which is identical to this one. To do this, we have to determine the variable which will determine the offset of this edge from the wing in parallel. Next we have those sub areas. The division in this direction is determined by the division of the walls, and division in this direction has to be determined by us now for these purposes. And the last one is this sub area, which is identical to this one, and division in this direction is determined by the division of this sub area, and division is in this direction will be determined by division of this area. I suggest to set this division to 1. Okay, and next we will have to make a couplings between those points and those points. In the previous video we made a component which has output which create those areas and those points which is necessary to make this connection. Also the same situation in walls. So but before we will start, I really encourage you to subscribe to my channel and smash the like button. I really appreciate that. It's motivating me to making further videos, and I would also like to thank you for first 100 subscribers. It's really meaningful for me, and without any further elongation, let's get started. Let's start it with defining the sub area between walls and wings, because the division in this direction and this direction for this sub area is determined. So to do this, we have to find those points from the bottom of the wing, and we only need points from one wing because those wings are symmetrical and identical to each other, and also the wings on the other side of the bridge. And we also need the points from the bottom of the wall's edge. And then we will create a vectors between the corner point, so corner between wing and the wall, and the points from this edge, from the bottom of the wall. Okay, so let's find the needed points. Points from wing should be found somewhere there, because points were determined there. Our component has an output which allows us to take those points. Okay, let's assign it to this component, and now we need to find those points. Those points should be defined somewhere here, yes, because there is definition of the wall. And points are here. Okay, now we can see that points from the wing are listed as a list, and points from the wall are listed as a tree. So let me check the order here and simplify. Okay, so we have 11 branches. Each branch represents the distance, the area between beams and between beam and the edge. And this number represents number of points that can be found in this area perpendicular to bridge's axis. So in this area we have the first point and the second point, so two in total here. For this area between these two beams we have the first point, the second point and the third point, so three in total, and so on and so on. So you can also spot it that points between sub areas are duplicated. So we have to flatten this list and remove the duplicates, and to be 100% sure, order those points by sorting the list on global X coordinate. Okay, so let's use the component which remove the duplicates. You can find it in vectors and point and cool duplicates component. Okay, apply and flatten this list. There is a input which determine the tolerance. I suggest to make really small tolerance because we know that our points are exactly in the same place. So to avoid duplicated points that we are not considering as duplicates, because sometimes distance between points can be really really small, and we want this distance to be small. So to avoid nulling or canceling those points, let's use really small tolerance value. Okay, now you can see that before nulling or canceling the duplicates we had 28 elements in total, but now we have 18. Okay, so it looks like it's working. Okay, now let's sort this list in X direction. So we have to deconstruct the points, and as a key input let's use the X. Okay, now our points should be sorted correctly. Let me check to be 100% sure. This is the first point and the last point, and so on and so on. Okay, so it's good. Okay, now let's take the first point from this list and create a vector between two points. Go to vector again as a subcategory, and use vector 2-point component between the first point and between the rest of those points. Okay, and now we can add those vectors to those points. Let's do this. Now you can see this trajectory of these points is not what we expected to be. To fix it up, we have to graph some of the input. So we have to graph vectors or the points. I suggest grafting points because for me it's more intuitive to organize, to order this tree in the structure. We have six branches and each branch is correlated with point on this wing, and number of points of this wing's edge is much smaller than the points on this edge, so it's more intuitive to check it out in the future if something will go wrong. I hope it will not. Okay. Fantastic. Okay, but before that, we have to remember that we have to cut the start and the ending points of this list, and then we will have to cut the end points on from this list here and the points from this list here to make the structural areas for sophistic in the same way as we did for deck and for the wall. Okay, so use our component. Where is it? Here it is. So our points are here without last elements. We can copy that. Okay. Now we have to remove this list and this list of points and check the result. So here we have top left points, top right points, bottom left points, and bottom right points. Now use 4-point surface component and make it in correct order. Okay, areas are created. Now use the sophistic structural area component. It can be found here, but we will create our own one. So let's do this. Okay, firstly we have to flip the local z vector, so go to primitive, so go to input and volume toggle, change to true. Okay, material of reinforcement should be 1, I guess. For concrete should be 1 and for reinforcement should be 2. 10, sorry, again. 1 and 2. Okay. So the same as here. And also we will need single quad text. Okay, so let's copy it. Go here. And here is material, reinforcement material, and single quad as mesh options. Okay, we also have to determine the thickness, and as you can see, this foot was badly modeled by us in purpose. Why? Let me show you on our goal model. You can see that there is a gap between walls and foot, and the height of this gap is exactly the half of the foot's thickness. That's why we use the kinematic constraints to connect the foot with the rest of the model. But because we use GlassTick, we can only change those points to fix this mistake. Okay, but first let's determine the thickness of the foot from, I guess, there, from there. You can set it to 1 meter and 20 centimeters. Foot's thickness in meters. Okay, go to thickness, and now we have to divide this value by 2. So use the equation component, divide it by 2 and create vector in z direction, and also make this value negative because we have to go down in our model. Okay, so go to math and negative component. Now add this vector to our points from this edge. We don't have to add this vector into those points because those points were only used to determine the vector which will be added to those points, and the coordination system of those points determine the elevation or the position of the foot. Okay, so let's do this. Now you can see those points are lower, and just change this the value of this spill. Okay, we can make it hidden, and everything is done. Now we can apply this structural area into our Teddy file. Let's do this. We can also flatten this input. It's not necessary, but sometimes it makes those components working faster. Go to Teddy, reload the file, and calculate the geometry. Okay. Here it is, and as you can see, these surfaces are defined correctly. The top edge of the foot is exactly at the same elevation as the bottom edge of the wing and the walls, so it's correct. Okay, let's go on to determine those sub areas from this side and from this side. Okay, so let's go. Okay, we need those points, and also we have to determine the vector in this direction. We have already done it for all of these points, so let's take the last vector from this list, because the first vector is from this corner point to this corner point, so this point has all three coordinates set to zero. That's why it's better to take the last one or the second one. Every, but not the first one. Okay. Yes, it is. Now we can make this vector as a unit vector. So go to vector and change the amplitude. Amplitude should be set to 1. Yes, it is in default mode. Okay. Now we have to rotate this vector to get vector pointed in this direction, not in this direction, or only we can use the negative component. Now let's determine the length of this edge extended from the wing, but in parallel to this wing. Let's do it from 0 to even 1 meter with 1 centimeter of precision. Foot's exterior offset in meters. Okay. Set it to half of the meter, and now we have to deconstruct this vector. Where is it? Deconstruct this vector. Here it is. To get the x value of this component. Okay, let's take the absolute value from it and subtract our foot exterior offset by this value. Now we get what the length of this vector in the direction of this edge, taking into consideration that the x component of this vector should be half of the meter. Okay, so let's make this vector as long as this value and make it negative. Okay, now you can see that if we deconstruct this vector, the x component should be negative half and the y should be negative something. Okay, okay, fantastic. Now we can add this vector to those points. We have them there, so just add vector to these points. Okay, if you want to have a control of the division in this direction, let's just make a lines between those, between these points and these points, and divide them as we did previously in deck, from 1 or from 1 to 3, I guess, maximum, reasonable maximum value. Let's take a 2. Before that we have to divide those, we have to remove the first line from this list and the second and the last line of this list to create these two lists. Thanks to our component, it's really simple. Okay, and reuse this component to divide them in this direction, to reorganize them in this direction, reorder. Okay, go to surfaces and do this in the same way. Okay, the thickness of this area and also the material and the reinforcement material are the same as in this area, so let's make material hidden, reinforcement hidden, thickness and mesh options. Flip Z can mean different, and of course breadth, so the structural area also will be different. Okay, so you can see in this case we don't have to flip the Z axis, so let's set it to false and apply the results. Okay, now reload the file, recalculate. And see it again. Okay, it's working. So let's go to the similar area but on the other side. We have to take in this case these points and move them down. Okay, so let's find them. They should be there. Yes, they are. Let's move them down in the same way as we did previously. And we can use this vector. We have already defined primitives and vector, but we don't have to negate this vector because we want this vector to be pointed in this direction. Okay. Now add this vector into those points. Oh, sorry. Okay. Now create the lines. So to be honest, we can just copy this fragment also with this one, and we have to substitute the input points. Okay. Let me check the orientation. Orientation is different in this case. Okay. Apply structural areas and check it out. Okay. Now let's open the animator, and as you can see, everything is done correctly. So this part is done. Now let's make this bigger area in the interior of the bridge. Okay, so to do this we need all of these points. We have already defined them. They are here, but we have to only take the first element from this list and then add vector to it. Okay, and add this vector. Sorry, add this vector. So we have to use the add component. Okay, fantastic. And now we have to create a variable which will determine the offset of the edge into interior of this bridge under the deck. Okay, so let's set it from 1 meter to even 3 meters with 1 centimeter of precision. Let's set foot's interior offset in meters. Okay, create a vector in y direction and add it in to these points. Okay, I guess 1.5 should be enough. Okay, now we have to create the lines in this direction as we did previously. We can also copy it, but we will determine the division in this direction as a new separate value variable. Let's set it to 5 and connect those points and those points. Okay, area is done. Now use the structural area component from Sophistic. Orientation of local Z axis is correct. Apply the changes and we will check the results later to not waste the time. We can also oriented the local X axis in global Y axis direction, because as you can see in this case red vector is pointed in this direction. In this case red vector is pointed in this direction, and if we don't do this, then during the defining the orientation of the reinforcement for the BMS component which designed the concrete areas, concrete surfaces, we will have to make different orientation of this reinforcement for every sub-area, which is uncomfortable and necessary complication of the model. So let's use the Y vector and add it into direction of the local X axis. Okay, here and here and also here. Okay, and now everything is oriented in the same way. Okay, the last one is this area and the corresponding area on the other side. Okay, to create it we need those points and those points. We will also create a vector in this direction as we did for this area and for this area. Ok, Okay. No, sorry, for only for this area. Okay. Or just we can we can copy those points here, create a line with the same division as this edge, as a third method to define those surfaces. Okay. So it was determined here without last. In this case we need the first on or the last line, in this case the first one, and it will be always the first line. Okay, division the same. Now we have to find this is vector in y direction, so just add it to these points. Okay, and create the line as in the same way as we did here. So let's copy it. Connect. Okay. Keep the same division in this direction as for this area. Check the local orientation. Okay. Apply the results and repeat this process for last sub area of the foot. So we need to take those points from this list. Okay. Here are line and the division of this line and this vector, and the line and other stuff is the same. Okay, add, check the local coordination of the z-axis. Okay, and apply the final component. Now we can reload the file and check if whole foot from the first side is correctly defined. Yes, it is. Okay, so now we have to repeat this process for the foot on the other side. I suggest to group it and create the similar group of components next to it and substitute some components from here. Okay, so there we don't have to take those points, we have to substitute those points by those points. So let's check it. Should be there. Yes, there is. Okay. Now look farther. So this is correct. Next. This is not correct. This should be done in the opposite direction, so we don't have to negate this vector in this case. Oh, sorry, we have to. Ah, sorry, it was done well. In this case I guess we have to, or we should not. Why this is the same as previously? Ah, sorry, because we have to substitute those points. Okay, by those points. Okay, now we can see. them here. Let's also change the orientation of local axis, local z axis, and here, okay. This part is completely broken, and those surfaces are in the same area as the surfaces from the interior of the foot. So I guess we have to change the orientation, the sign of this y vector. So let's make it negative. Okay, now it's looking much better. Check the orientation change. I guess also we have to change this one. Yes, and the last one here. Okay. We also have to substitute variables from there by the variables from this one, because we want those foots to be the same. So to not make a mistake, just substitute this value and delete. In this case, it can be there, this cannot be. Foot exterior offset, substitute, also the divisions, division here. Division here is okay. Okay. Foot interior offset should be changed. Okay. This division also. Sorry. And I think that's all. Also, we have to change the orientation of the local x vector, because from the first side it was pointed from the sole into interior, and here it's pointed also in the same way, and we want it to be pointed into interior. And also we can see that this y vector is defined only for these four components, and those two have a separate component, which is unnecessary. We can fix it now. Okay, fix, and also there, fix. Fantastic. Okay, and make this vector negative. Okay, now we can apply those components into our model. Take this pill and collect all of this structural areas. And find some already connected component. And now we can check the teddy. Reload, recalculate. As you can see, there is no warning about interaction of the surfaces, so it's okay. And the second foot is done also correctly. Now, the last thing we have to do is making the coupling between those upper edges and those lower edges. Okay, so let's find those points. Here it is. So use the component from Sophistic for making couplings from these points into these points. Okay. group later, fix full translation and full rotation. Okay, this will be the same for all of these elements, so we can hide in this input. Now let's find this edge. This edge is here. Okay. In this case, I think we can use those points which are defined in tree structure, because it will be, I guess, simple for us later to group those points. But also I think that we can do it in other way, so let's take the sorted and cancelled and nullified points. Okay, we have to move them from the top to the bottom using this component, which moved those points down, and repeat this process for it. First one, second one. Also create those kinematic constraints from the top points into the bottom points, because the deformation of these points should be the same as the deformation of these points in the foot area, because foot will be done firstly in our model during construction stage modeling process. Okay, and the last one is nowhere, because we have to take those points. Ah, sorry, I get they are here and are moved down right here. Go. Okay, so all complex from the first side are done. We can also see that couplings from this edge and couplings from this edge had one duplicate coupling here, but it doesn't matter for the results of the walls and wings and foot. Also, if you want to have accurate reactions of the couplings in this area, but you don't need them. They are only needed to transfer every forces and displacement from the foot into the upper part of this bridge. Okay, use the peel component, add all of them and copy this part, because the same should be done for the other side. Okay, the first one are points from this wing, so upper points and bottom points from the top to the bottom. The second one is here, and we have to take this component which move points from the top to the bottom. What is going on? Sorry, not this one, but somewhere here. Where is it? Sorry, I completely missed that. There is it. Should be the same. I don't understand. Ah, because those points are from the other side, and it didn't mix up, and it didn't mix up our model for the foot of the on the other side, because those points was only used to determine the direction of this edge, and the direction of this edge and of this edge is the same. So let's change it to those points. Okay, I guess, yes. Okay, foot didn't change. but this results changed. Okay. Now it's correctly done. Add and add. Okay, and the last one is somewhere here. Yes, it is. So from the bottom, some points from the top and points from the bottom. Okay, connect the pills. And apply this pill into our model and remove those pills. Done, done, and done. Okay, we can also add those kinematic constraints into this group. Add to group. To be honest, select everything and now add to group, because we also added some other components into this green area, and the same for the second green area. Okay, check the sophistic. And kinematic constraints are defined, as you can see. You can also check if the connection is correct. So we have point 1078 from this side of this kinematic constraint. The same for the kinematic constraint, 1079. There is 1080, and here is also 1080 for all of the surrounding surfaces. Okay, check the thickness again, also made correctly. So that's all. So today we finished modeling our structure above ground level. In next episode we focus on modeling the foundation of this bridge. We will model two types of the foundation: the direct one, which will be modeled as a spring element, and indirect one, which will be modeled as a steel piles using HASE program in Sophistic. So see you later in next episodes. Remember to subscribe and smash the like button. I really appreciate that. Thanks for watching and see you later. Bye.